Now, as far as a force pump is concerned, we have this piston right here. This is where the pumping takes place. As we are pumping water, we are having two valves. We have valve A right there. We have valve B right there. These two valves are going to keep opening. One will open as the other closes, then one will close as the other opens. And as a result, we are able to get water right here. We have a reservoir right there. It only ensures that we are having a steady supply of water, regardless of whatever is going on right here. So let's look at the upstroke of a force pump. Now, by upstroke, I mean that this piston is moving up. And now, of course, when this piston moves up as a result of upstroke, it means that when you look at valve A, the pressure on top of valve A is going to reduce, and the pressure here below valve A is going to increase as a result of this atmospheric pressure. So this atmospheric pressure is what causes the pressure here to increase. So as you pull this thing up, the pressure on top of valve A is going to reduce, and the pressure below valve A is going to be stronger, and so it will push this valve to open up. However, as this is happening because of this piston being pulled up, what happens to valve B? Of course, valve B is going to drop. It is going to close. It will fall down by gravity because there is no more pressure that is forcing it to go open. So those are the two things that happen during the upstroke. Now, what about the downstroke? During the downstroke of a force pump, the force being exerted by this piston causes this pressure on top of the valve to be higher than the atmospheric pressure down here. So as a result, valve A will be closed. And when valve A is closed, this pressure is going to cause valve B to open. And when valve B is caused to open as a result of this pressure caused due to the downstroke, then you have water coming out of here. So we are going to look at the lift pump. In the lift pump, still we have two valves. We have valve A right here and valve B right there. And in either stroke, one of these valves will be closed and the other one open. Now, during the upstroke, of course, during the upstroke, this valve B is going to close this hole. It will just drop and close as a result of, and as you're pulling, this thing goes up, the pressure on top of valve A is going to reduce, and the atmospheric pressure below here is going to force this water to push valve A open. So meaning during upstroke, valve A is going to open and valve B will remain closed. Why? Drop back and close, but then valve A will just open up because the atmospheric pressure, which is below valve A, is going to be greater than the pressure that was on top of valve A. So now what happens during the downstroke of a lift pump? During the downstroke of the lift pump, of course, the water below this valve A will automatically drop and it will close as a result of the force below here, as a result of the force on top of this valve A. So the valve A is going to close, and as this piston is moving downwards, when this water here that has been trapped has caused this valve to close, the pressure will increase here, and the pressure down in this barrel, as it increases, it's going to cause this valve B to open. And that will make this water to be pushed out.